Hi folks, this is All the Fruit. I am at Satok Market in Kuching in Borneo. We are right in the fruit season. There is everything you can expect from a Borneo market. And still, somehow I am not happy. I realized I got really spoiled by the Borneo markets. I was for 11 days in Peninsular Malaysia in Penang, making tons and tons of videos every day and complaining that we are not in the fruit season. Here I'm in Borneo, a place with arguably a lot more fruit even than Peninsular Malaysia. I'm right in the fruit season. There is everything I can expect and still I'm not happy because I am happy, but I've been in Borneo for 2 days now and I didn't make a single video. Why? Because I guess I've been here so many times that it's getting quite hard to find new and interesting stuff in the same places. But still, I want to show you all the stuff you can see in January in the main fruit market of Kuching, the capital of Sarawak. There are a lot of notable differences between Sarawak and Kalimantan or Sarawak and West Malaysia, and I want to explore some of those. Well, one thing is, in Sarawak we have a lot of different banana variety, species, hybrids, whatever, and a lot of them, they even put proper labels on them, from the giant pisang tandok to the tiny pisang hotel over there. Lots and lots of bananas. Here at this stall they also have a lot of different coconuts from different trees or varieties. I think I'll come back later and have another coconut. Sweet potatoes, lemongrass, banana and ginger leaves for wrapping. This is some sort of taro. Here the infamous betel nut. When you chew this, you spit out the betel juice. Just look at the variety of those bananas. In this stall alone, they must have like between 8 and 10 different bananas. Cucumbers, I think those are the ones which are supposed to be eaten green in a salad, but once they get ripe, I guess you can cook them just like the cooking cucumbers here. Manioc. Huge pineapples. Yesterday we weighed one of those, about the size of this one, and it was exactly 5 kilos, so they can get quite big. Soursop and papayas. Mangoes. The mangoes here are really different from the mangoes in Peninsular Malaysia as well as the mangoes in Kalimantan. Like, this mango looks from the shape like the ones in Peninsular Malaysia, even in Thailand. But as you can see, it's not such a nice bright yellow. It's a dirty mix of yellow, green, and brown. This is some local variety, and I still need to find out the name. This should be Assam Putaran, smelly wild jungle mangoes, champedak, and huge jackfruit. More champedak, different gingers. This should be galang, and the other one is maybe some small ginger. Onions and potatoes and pumpkins, which look a lot like in our areas. More sweet potatoes. This is pois crunch, some sort of tamarind like tasty fruit. I forgot the name of those nuts over there. Is pois. I knew them. I even made the video about it. This is a local nut which you can cook and eat. The ferns they collect in the wild for cooking. The famous sour Borneo eggplant. Oh, lots of different sour rattan fruit. Here we have right next to the sour eggplants, we have cooking cucumbers and some ginger flowers. This is those are manioc leaves and young shoots for cooking. This one, oh, asam paya, asam asam. Yes. They just tried to introduce me to the most sour fruit in the world, but they already knew it. And here this lady is cutting open the biggest tree fruit in the world, the jackfruit. Here I get the diversity of the local gingers. Curcuma, ginger, this should be galang. I don't even know the names of the other gingers here. I don't know what this here is. Big diversity of limes also. Here again, the local jungle mangoes, Assam Putaran. This is Mangifera foetida. This here is Bambagan, the giant smelly mango. What was it called? Mangifera payag or something like this. Here, they use ginger stems for cooking. They use unripe jackfruit, and this should be the base of some, maybe of some nipa palms for cooking. Sometimes they prepare the stuff for cooking and they just sell you one bag, or sometimes they just tie it up with a little ribbon, just like the market vendors in Germany do. In Germany they also sell you like a little bundle of stuff you can put in your soup. Here we have the flowers of the torch ginger at Lingere Lazior. Here we have okra, stink beans. The market is huge. I will not be able to show you anything. And the funny thing is, here in the fruit and veg section, there are some sellers of dry goods. More ferns and gingers, dragon bean and sweet leaf, mint, basil. Don't even know what this is. Should be some, should be something in the Oligonaceae. This is some Artemisia. This should be the inside of some palm, or maybe it's also part of the jackfruit. Here again, some Oligonaceae. Lots and lots of chilies. They sure love their chilies. I don't so much. Let's see what else we have. If you've seen maybe five of my... here we have Judas ear mushrooms. Tampoi, one of the sweetest and tastiest fruit of Borneo. Dried up pepper. Here are the seeds, the beans of the stink bean. If you've seen my other videos about Borneo markets, basically you will not find anything new here. I just think it's so exciting that I'm at such a wonderful, giant, plentiful, diverse market and there is nothing new. Here we have bamboo stems for cooking, pomelos, bittergourd, eggplants. I don't know if you've noticed, but in Borneo markets, fruit are a lot more prominent, especially in Sarawak markets, than in most other markets in Southeast Asia. Maybe because I'm in the fruit season, maybe for other reasons, but a lot more fruit. Durian is dirt cheap right now. You get them from 2 ringgit a piece, and if you buy a whole pile of them, even cheaper. Mangosteen, we are still quite early in the mangosteen season. They are trying to provide a lot of mangosteen everywhere, but it's a little bit underripe still in most cases. I think I can recognize the Pisagotel, but I cannot recognize most of the other bananas around here. Let's see what else we have. Oh yes, tarap. Voila. Of the tastiest fruit of Borneo. It's very hard to get outside of Borneo. I don't even know what this is. Again, more and more and more bananas. Well, the bananas are a staple in tropical countries. They don't only eat them as a fruit, but also as a vegetable. They fry them. Here again, cooking cucumbers and the endemic sour eggplant, which is very hard to find outside of Borneo. It should be more common everywhere in the tropics. It's such a tasty vegetable. I can only recommend it to you. Here some umbrellas, Pondias dulcis. Here big sorso. Durian, durian, durian. Look, here you can get 4 to 5 durians for 10 ringgit. That's about €2. egg color. This is actually quite rare on big markets outside of the jungle, but you find it from time to time. An avocado-like fruit, very interesting. Oh, here even more egg color. Again, lots of different limes, lots of different gingers. Here again are some papaya, maybe the most sour fruit in the world. Here again, tons and tons of different gingers. Here again, another ginger. There are hundreds of ginger and related species here in Southeast Asia. And those people in Borneo, they have found the use for almost everyone. Fresh green pepper. This is so much tastier than the dried up stuff. Wax gourds and pumpkins. Ooh. This is some interesting lime lemon like thingy. Well, the thing is, basically everything, you know, with lemons and limes, there is not such a big quality and official variety control, because as long as the tree grows well, fruits well, and the fruit are sour and have no big issues, you can use them. So look how many different limes and lemons they have here. This is like basically almost every mutation in your lime and lemon trees. You can still use them because it's really not such the requirements towards the lemon is just being sour and tasty and fruiting a lot. Here again, Enkala. Here is the more red variety and also more ripe. Umbarella. Oh yeah, durian season. Here, coconuts of different colors, some beautiful orange ones among the green ones. Ooh, is this some giant champedak? This could be like a 7 or 8 kilo champedak. Those here are jackfruit, those two, but the rest is champedak. This here should be a big champedak. Wow, that's big for a champedak. See, folks, there is so much stuff here, and this is only the normal weekday market. On the weekends, it gets really crazy and like 5 times bigger than now. Here again, tarap, such a tasty fruit, and only one of dozens of artocarpos, which are very hard to get outside of Borneo. I wonder why. I really wonder if I should get the third durian today. I already ate 2 pretty big ones. Duku Langsat. Most of those fruit are really sour, but if you find a batch of sweeter ones, they are amazing. I think those peppers here were called rose peppers. Here again, a different, 2 different varieties of Borneo, but no, at least 3 or 4 different ones. Look at those small ones, bigger ones, really big ones, even bigger ones, and the giant mango king. Those should be like 1.5 kilo a piece. Yeah, the mangoes here are really interesting, but few people can provide me with proper names for them. What a pity. Let's see, I will not continue much longer. Okay, the video is already over 13 minutes. If I would go on for like 25 minutes, I could find about 4 or 5 more fruit. Here, yellow rambutan and pink bananas. Oh, yeah, here, Dabai, the Borneo olive. One of the most intriguing fruit of Borneo. Especially interesting for vegans. Vegans who come to Borneo, they have a lot of nice alternatives to avocado. I haven't seen a single avocado here. It doesn't seem to be in season. Here, some really pink bananas. More Duku Langsat. Okay, folks. So, I'm finishing this video. I'm sure I'll find at least 10 new things after I finish the video and continue walking around, but it's always like this on big markets. Stay tuned for a lot more fruit videos from the beautiful island of Borneo. And don't forget to like, share, comment, and subscribe.